If you're running search campaigns in Google Ads, then you need to group your keywords correctly. By taking the time to group keywords, you'll have a better campaign and ad group structure in your account. This means you can show the best possible ad for the different keywords you are targeting. And by showing the best possible ad, people are more likely to click through to your website and convert. Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, I'm going to show you how to group keywords in your Google Ads account. We're going to cover how to manually group keywords and how to automatically group keywords using the new Organize Keywords feature in the Keyword Planner. Let's jump in and get started. I've already logged into my Google Ads demo account. I use this account when I'm teaching people how to set up and manage their campaigns in my Google Ads courses. The account has a small monthly budget, and I'm currently using it to promote my Google Analytics glossary. The way you begin to group your keywords will depend on if you already have an active campaign or if you're creating a new campaign from scratch. If you are starting from scratch, then you'll want to use the Keyword Planner to research an initial list of keywords. Let's take a look at this before we cover the approach to use for any of your existing campaigns. Let's select Tools and Settings, and then Keyword Planner. If we're researching keywords for a new campaign, we select Discover New Keywords. And then we can enter some initial keyword ideas to begin our research. I'm going to enter three initial terms that are related to what I want to promote, which is my Google Analytics glossary. So I'm going to enter Google Analytics glossary, Google Analytics terms, and Google Analytics dictionary. You should enter some keywords that relate to what you want to promote with your ads. Then when you're ready, click Get Results. We can now start building our initial list of keywords. For my campaign, I'm going to select terms that relate to my offer, so things like Google Analytics terminology, Google Analytics terminology cheat sheet, Google Analytics terms definitions, and so on. You'll want to spend some time considering each of the suggestions in the Keyword Planner. And for a more in-depth walkthrough, check out my dedicated Keyword Planner tutorial. I've included a link in the card and in the description below this video. Once you have a list of keywords, it's time to develop a structure for your ad groups. Let's click Save Keywords to add them to our draft keyword plan. You can also check to see if Google Ads has any useful suggestions by clicking on Keyword View above the table on the right, and then selecting Grouped View. This can provide automated suggestions for grouping the keywords. However, for my keywords, it doesn't look particularly useful, so let's switch back to the Keyword View instead. Okay, so another option we can use is the new Organize Keywords feature. Let's select this. By default, this will try to automatically place the keywords we've researched into our top performing campaigns. But there's also an option to manually select the campaigns we want to use. I'm going to leave Use Top Performing Campaigns selected, and let's click Auto Organize Keywords. For my campaigns and keywords, it hasn't provided any suggestions. So hopefully this feature improves in the future. So we will still manually structure our keywords into ad groups. The other issue I've found when using the Organize Keywords feature is there's no option to add keywords from the tool into our existing campaigns. Maybe I'm missing something, but it seems like the only option is to download the keywords and then import them back into Google Ads. So my preference is to export the keywords and then choose which campaigns and ad groups they should be placed in. And just to highlight, the reason we're structuring our keywords into different ad groups is so that we can then write really engaging ads for each ad group. It means we can be really targeted with the copy we write so that we're appealing to people as they're searching. Let's navigate back to Keyword Ideas. And let's select a keyword we want to add to our account. We can then click More and Add to Account. This lets us select the ad group where we want to add the keyword, along with the match type. This is an option, but it can become time-consuming if you're looking to add more than a handful of keywords. So let's close this. This time, let's click the download icon. And I'm going to select the option to download the keywords to Google Sheets. And let's open the spreadsheet. We can now use this spreadsheet to decide where we want to place these keywords in our account. One way to do this is to add two extra columns to the spreadsheet. We will use one for the campaign and the other for the ad group. We can now go through our list of keywords and note down where we want to place each keyword. When we're done, we can then copy the keywords into Google Ads. Okay, now let's take a look at how we can group keywords if we have an existing campaign. Let's head back to Google Ads. Again, this is my demo account, so let's select the blog search campaign to take a look. We can see the campaign only has a single ad group, which probably isn't ideal. Let's select keywords to review the keywords we're currently bidding on. We can see there are just a handful of keywords in the ad group, which is good, but there is room for improvement. If we were to restructure this campaign so that it had multiple ad groups, we would be able to write ads that are more targeted to the different keywords. For example, instead of having Google Analytics Glossary and Google Analytics Dictionary in the same ad group with the same ads, we could have these in their own ad groups with ads that are written specifically for each keyword theme. So let's start by splitting the keywords into separate ad groups. Let's create a new ad group. Let's name it Terms. Let's enter a default bid. And let's add the keyword Google Analytics Terms. And create the ad group. Since we're focused on grouping keywords, I'm going to skip creating and adjusting ads. But in your account, you should take time to write ads that closely relate to the keywords contained in the ad group. Now let's create another ad group. Let's name this one Terminology. Enter a default bid. Add the keyword Google Analytics Terminology. And create the ad group. Let's create another ad group. Let's name it Definitions. Enter a default bid and add the keyword Google Analytics Definitions. And create the ad group. Now we need to select the original ad group, and we need to pause the keywords we've added to the new ad groups. If you have additional keywords in the original ad group, then you can manually add these to the most appropriate ad group in the campaign. And you might need to create additional ad groups if you're managing lots of keywords. I recommend doing this manually, but you can also try the automatic organization feature we looked at previously. Let's briefly look at this again to see if we get better results this time. Let's select Tools and Settings. And then Keyword Planner. Now let's select the option on the right that says Organize Keywords into Ad Groups. I already have a list of additional keywords that I want to add to my campaign, so I'm going to select the Upload or Paste tab. and I'm going to paste the keywords. And let's click Auto Organize Keywords. We can see it's done a slightly better job at suggesting where the keywords should be placed in our existing ad groups, but there's room for improvement. So it might help give you some ideas, but you are likely to still manually structure the keywords in your campaigns and ad groups. Please remember that the option to automatically group keywords is just that, it's automated. While it might work well for some accounts, it doesn't mean that it will be better than the decisions you make for your account. You always have the option of manually grouping your keywords in Google Ads. How are you grouping keywords? Automatically or manually? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you haven't already, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel for all of my latest tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.